据说只有500人居住啊。
I heard that there's only 500 people live there.
那我在那几天呢，感触很深。
So it really got me thinking when I was there.
那其中一个呢，就是我感觉到那里的人真的是过着一种简单快乐的生活。
One of the things is that I saw the people there really lead a very simple and happy life.
那真的是非常让人羡慕。
And I really enjoy it. I really like that.
那么当我离开的时候啊，我的心中甚至有一种淡淡的这种恋恋不舍的感觉。
So just when I depart, there's this sadness in my heart.
特别是当我们的船向着奥克兰快要到码头的时候啊，回头一看啊，再回过头来看一看奥克兰，那种心中啊就产生了一种恐惧或者是厌倦的感觉。
Especially when our ship about to arrive Auckland, when I look back,
那一瞬间呢、啊，千万般想法涌上心头。
Just at that very moment, a lot of thoughts come to my mind.
我忽然想到说，我们真的是生活在一个充满了危机的世界。
And it got me thinking, we really live in a dangerous world here.
我马上就想到啊，那个曾经在非洲比较肆虐的这个埃博拉病毒。
So I was thinking about the Ebola virus in Africa.
那我当时呢，我忽然想起来，这个有一天我儿子放学回家呀，他非常认真地问我，他说：“你真的到过非洲去吗？”
So one day Richard came home and asked me very seriously, Dad, did you really went to Africa before?
啊，我说是啊，我说真的是我去过。
And I said yes, I did.
他马上就跟我讲了，他说：“哎呀，我真的是很佩服你，因为那里真的是非常危险。”
And he looked at me and he said, I really admired you, Dad, because that was a really dangerous place.
我就问他为什么。
And I asked him why.
他说：“你知道埃博拉吗？”
He said, Do you know Ebola?
然后他就给我唱了一首他写的歌。
And then he sang a song.
是一个绕舌歌曲啊 ，I got Ebola.
So it's a rap called I got Ebola.
那意思就是说呢，我们每个人都传染上埃博拉了。你从我这儿传染，他从他那儿传染，反正最后大家都没法幸免，我们都得病了。
So the song goes like, something like, We all got Ebola. You got it from me. I got it from him. And we all gonna have Ebola. And we're going to die.
我当时就在船上，我就想啊，哎呀，这个看来应该是很遥远的事情。我忽然就想起来呢，其实不是。前几天呢，我去北安医院去急诊那边啊，发现在急诊的窗口呢，贴着一个通知，上面写着说，如果你近期曾经到西非地区去旅行，请你马上通知值班护士。
So I thought this was far away from us, but then I remember when I went to the hospital and I saw this notice on the window and it says, if you've been to Africa recently.Please notify the nurses.
我忽然感觉啊，这个其实离我们并不遥远，那种致命的病毒原来就在我们身边呢。
And all of a sudden, I think that this lethal virus is not as far away from us as we thought.
那么最近呢是假期哈、啊，很多弟兄姐妹都有朋友啊，有亲人呐、啊，我们自己啊，我们会飞来飞去啊。
You know, this is the festive seasons and holiday seasons. We probably travel to all the places by airplane.
那么你有没有想到啊2014年的过去的一年呢，绝对是可以称为是各家航空公司最悲剧的一年。
So have you ever thought that, you know, in the year 2014, it was a devastating year for those airliners?
这个马航的事情呢，我们就不多说了啊。
So we probably won't talk too much about Malaysian Airlines.
那前两天在微信上有这么一个段子啊，不知道大家是否看到。
This story been going on online. I don't know if you heard about this.
然后在前两天说亚洲杯中国足球队男足终于赢球了啊，人们就问说为什么呢？
This soccer the Asian Cup, and then the ever losing Chinese national soccer team have all won the game.
那么在亚洲杯之前呢，哈，这个段子上讲的哈，说这个习近平呢就找着这个中国体育总局局长谈话。他说：“我不管你是用洋教练还是土教练，你踢得好了，我就到机场来接你；踢得不好呢，岐山书记就到机场去接你。”
So there was the story saying that the Chinese premier Xi, he talked to the head of the sports department and says that I don't care what sort of coach you use or whatever method you use. If you want the games, I'm going to the airport.If not, just wait for your disciplinary actions.
然后呢，这个体育总局局长呢，他就去找这个教练和队员谈话了。他说：“你们注意哈，如果踢得好呢，就坐澳航回来；这个踢得不好呢，就要坐马航。
” So he said to the team members, "If you did well, we'll fly backwards Australian airline. If not, we'll probably compete with Malaysian airlines.
其实我们都知道，过去的一年不只是马航啊，还有亚航。
Not only Malaysian airlines, there's also Air Asia.
绝对就悲剧啊
！And that was a tragedy.
其实这样的事情呢，可能我们每一天都会遇到。我不是下午要坐飞机离开的这些弟兄姐妹们啊。
Have you ever thought that these things are actually quite close to us? It could happen to just you and me.
前两天呢，我看到这样一个新闻哈，说一架马航的班机呢，它在起发之前，起飞之前发生了发动机故障，但是很快就排除了。但是全体的乘客呢，大家马上都站起来拒绝这个登机飞机起飞哈，说大家都被吓怕了。
I heard that in one instance, all the passengers refused to board the Malaysian Airlines out of fear because they found it's a fault before they take off. Even though this accident or this fault was very quickly got resolved, but they still don't want to board it.
有人就评论说啊，说从2015年开始，这将是一个集体对飞行恐惧的时代。
One said that, you know, from 2015, people gonna be a little bit frightened about going onto the airplane.
那么回到奥克兰之后呢，这几天世界动荡的新闻让我心中这种担忧就更加明显了。
After I come back to Auckland, I saw the unrest in the world, and it just got me thinking more and more.
那大家都知道前两天在法国发生了这个恐怖袭击事件。
So we might know that earlier this year there's the terrorist attack in France.
那么有一些武装分子呢，在七号那天在法国巴黎有一个叫《查理周刊》的杂志社啊，他们在那里造成了12个人的死亡，11个人的受伤。
So there was a terrorist attack in this place called Charlie's Tables. This is a magazine, their headquarters, and caused 12 dead and 11 injured.
那么在几天之后呢，在法国巴黎就有来自世界40多个国家的国家政要啊，参加了一次反恐大游行。这次游行呢，统计说有300多万人参加，这是历史上在法国举行的最大规模的一次公众游行。
So, 3 days after that, that's the 11th, there was a protest in Paris. So, political leaders from 40 countries actually attended this protest. This is to protest against terrorism. And it reported 3 million people attended, and that's one of the biggest protests in France.
其实在世界上让人们感到真正担忧的呢，其实并不是这个恐惧事件的本身。
So, what made people think it wasn't the terrorist attack itself?
而是说这件事情之后啊，各个国家的政要首脑他们发表了很多的谈话。
But it is after this attack, a lot of political leaders around the world they made some comments.
我去查了一下啊，最少包含了法国、德国和瑞士、瑞典几个国家的领导人呢，他们在重申呢，说我们要重新考虑多元文化和包容主义这个观念是不是正确。
So many European countries like France, Germany, Switzerland, and Sweden, they've been talking about they should reconsider the idea of multicultural in their society.
那么前两天在海外校园中有一篇文章就说呀，他说实际上呢，从信仰的角度来讲，这是一种宗教的冲突，是一种文化的冲突。
So this article saying that from the faith perspective, this is a conflict between cultures, a conflict between religions.
但是如果我们回头看一看历史呢，我们会发现世界总是在接触、融合、冲突，再到和平的过程这样不断发展。
And then when we look back, we see that throughout the human history, we see how many different ideas and cultures came into a harmonious coexistence through the different stages, the initial contacts, conflicts, and eventually acceptance.
但是我们知道呢，处在冲突这个阶段中的人，这绝对是不幸的。
But of course, we know that during the times of conflicts, the people who live in that times, it's a tragic for them.
那么，如果我们每一个人，我们是移民，我们在这个移民的社会中，如果我们处在这种冲突和动荡的时代呢，那就是我们个人的不幸。
So we know that we as immigrants, we move to a new culture, and if we live in such a world and there's conflicts, so that is perhaps very unfortunate for us.
其实生活里面不只是这些，我们说这些国际之间的大事，在我们生活里面呢，还有很多小的事情和我们息息相关的事情。
So, apart from these major events, there's also little things happening around us.
那比如说，我们看一看在大陆的新闻，说环境的恶化，75%的地下水，42%的土壤呢已经被污染。
So in China, 75% of groundwater, 42% of soil was contaminated.
至于空气的污染、雾霾呢，我们就不说，大家都知道。
And not to mention the smogs.
说到我们的食品，说我们曾经说在纽西兰，我们生活在一个幸福的国度，我们尽量避免去买那些不好的东西。说像作为我作为来一个大来自于大陆的人呢，说我们去买一些台湾和韩国产，后来发现呢，台湾产的也不好啊，它也有食用地沟油啊。
So now let's talk about the foods that we eat. I come from China, and back then we said, oh, maybe we should buy healthier foods or better foods from Taiwan or Korea. But now we find out that even in Taiwan, the Taiwanese food, they are recycled oils, which is really bad for us.
那最近很多弟兄姐妹去海边去摸贝壳啊，摸皮皮。那前一段时间呢，有一个 QA 朋友跟我讲啊，他说现在在纽西兰海边很多的这个贝类动物啊，不能吃了。
So, you know, some of you probably went to the beach and got peepees and things like that. But one of my friends told me that now you can't even have those as well.
他说有两个原因。
And there were two reasons for it.
他说一个呢是重金属污染，所以海边的贝类呢不易食用。
And one was because of the heavy metal contamination, so you can't eat it anymore.
他说另一个原因就是你们 Chinese 来了把它都吃没了。
The second reason is even if you want, but you Chinese actually ate them all, so we can't.
那么你想一想，在你身边中很多人很多事。
So think about the people around you.
在中国呢，我们都知道哈，说如果是一个老人跌倒，你扶不扶
？So like in China, if you saw an elderly person fall on the street, should you actually go and help him?
很多人说呢，现在没有人敢扶，因为大家都怕讹诈。
A lot of people say, no, you shouldn't or you can't because you might get conned.
那很多人就说呢，说这个是讨论呢，说现在这个时代。到底是老人变坏了呢，还是坏人变老了呢
？So these people are discussing whether it is the old people become bad or the bad people become old.
其实呢，不是老人的问题，而是我们身边我们每一个人，包括我们自己的问题，是我们大家呢都变坏。
And that is not the main reason. The main reason is that everyone, every single one of us, are bad.
你看一看你的身边啊，你想一想。经济发展的利益的冲突，各种意气之争，是不是就多起来了
？And let's look around and you see as this generation is more wealthy than the old generations, many conflict arise.
今天呢，有很多现代的通讯工具哈、啊，那么人与人之间的距离近了，那么人心中的自我呢，也就越来越明显。
As we see this many the communication technique is more advanced, so the distance between every single individual is shortened. However, the shortcomings are more apparent as well.
那么在你的生活里边，你有没有发现呢、啊？这个每个人在他身上是显现出这种贪婪呐、啊、诡诈呀、啊、虚伪啊，就越来越表现的明显。
So we can more easily to show and to see how selfish, greedy, deceptive, and how maybe at times pretending we are.
那么在你的生活中，你会不会突然间有的时候你会发现啊，原来跟你很亲密的朋友呢，原来是一个好像比较虚伪、两面三刀、口蜜腹剑的。
So maybe have you ever think that people around you, the people who are close to you, and one day you figure out that he's actually just pretending?
你会不会忽然发现呢，某一个人他原来是只为自己、为自己的利益可以突破一切底线的
？And maybe one can.Betray you or to give up anything else for his own interests and benefits.
当你面对这些人和这些事的时候，你会不会对这个世界你充满了失望
？So do you feel disappointed when you face these kind of people?
其实我们有的时候啊，我们反思一下，我们客观去看待一下这个世界的时候呢，我们真的很失望。原来我们所生活的这个世界，真的不是我们所希望的这个世界。
And when I think about it, it really disappoints me because this is really not the kind of world we want to live in.
每次我想到这些的时候呢，我就觉得很绝望，我就感到很伤感。
So whenever I think about this, it really makes me sad.
说这个世界为什么会这样
？What happened to this world?
我们站在2015年的开始，我们去展望一年、展望未来的时候，我们有没有信心说？我们的一切会变得越来越好。
At the beginning of 2015, when we look forward, are we confident to say that Yes, it will get better.
弟兄姐妹们，我可以告诉大家呢，不会变得更好。
So, dear brothers and sisters, I can tell you, no, it will not.
只会越来越坏。
And it will get worse and worse.
因为在圣经中，神早已经启示我们末后的日子会如何。
Because the Bible tells us what will happen in the last days.
在以赛亚书中，先知说：“你们要向天举目观看下地，因为天必像烟云消散，地必如衣服渐渐旧了，其上的居民也要如此死亡。”
So Isaiah 51, chapter 51, verse 6 says, "Lift up your eyes to heavens. Look at the earth beneath. The heavens will vanish like smoke. The earth will wear out like a garment.And its inhabitants died like flies."
那么圣经告诉我们一个道理呢，说我们所居住的世界，我们所居住这个世界中的人，他一定会变化，而且是越变越坏，就好像是一件衣服一样，重新不断的变旧。
So the Bible tells us that the world and the people on it will only get worse and worse, just like a garment from a new to old.
那么如果你去读圣经启示录。你会发现呢，在启示录中说到那末后的日子，他讲到说，在这个世界上必然有瘟疫、饥荒各样的天灾人祸，人心呢也会越变越坏，越变越差，所以民要攻打民，国要攻打国。
And the book of Revelation says that in the last days there will be plagues, famines, and earthquakes. Nations will rise against nations, and kingdoms against kingdoms.People will become more and more evil, and the world is going towards destruction.
所以弟兄姐妹们，我们就是生活在这样一个世界里。
And this is the kind of world we live in now.
这就是刚才我们读经在腓立比书中，使徒写到说这弯曲悖谬的时代。
And this is exactly the warped and crooked generation that the verses we just read.
弯曲悖谬，它的意思是说呢，一切的关系都扭曲了。一切的道理都错乱了。
So what does that mean? That means all the relationship were twisted, and the norm and standard becomes old-fashioned. The wrong things become right.
本来正常的变得不正常，本来错误的呢变得正确了，本来是耻辱的东西呢变成了光荣，本来应该被众人所唾弃的东西呢，现在变成了被人荣耀的东西。
So everything got twisted. What was deemed ashamed and now become honorable. I mean, people start to praise that.Was used to be condemned.
我们要问这个问题：为什么神要让我们生活在这样的一个世界
？And we probably need to ask the question: Why would God want us to live in a world like this?
在这样的一个世界里面，他付出代价救赎我们，他的目的是什么
？And what's His purpose in saving us from this world? Because He paid the price for it.
神通过圣经启示我们说，他要求我们。在这个弯曲悖谬的时代，我们要做神无瑕疵的儿女。你们显在这世代中，好像明光照耀，将生命的道表明出来。
So, God through the Bible tells us that we need to become blameless and innocent child of God, without fault in the warped and crooked generation. Then you will shine among them like a star in the sky.
神启示我们说，这个世界堕落，人心堕落。但是这并不是神创造的本意。
And this world and the hearts of those who live in it has fallen. This is not what God intended when He created this world.
神在创造的时候，他就知道有一天这个世界，我们这些人就会发展到这个地步。
So He knew at the very beginning that this world is going towards this way.
他任凭这个事情发生，他没有拦阻。
But He didn't intervene.
因为他要让我们知道，这是我们人类自己造成的后果。
And he wants us to know that there is a consequence of our own acts.
但是让我们感到欣慰的是，我们的神他并没有放弃我们。
However, the good news is that he didn't forsake us.
他给我们人类和这个世界留下了一条救赎之路。
And he gives a path to redemption.
他对这个世界的拯救和重新的更新是通过耶稣基督的工作来进行。
So his salvation is done through the works of Jesus Christ.
当耶稣基督救赎的工作完成之后。他把一个新的使命交给了他属于耶稣基督的那些人，就是我们那些基督徒身上。
So after Jesus Christ has completed His work, God gave His people, us the Christians, a new mission.
那么耶稣基督告诉我们说，他说你们在这个世界中，你们就应该像黑暗中的一束光一样。
So He wanted us to act like a light source, a light being in the darkness.
你们要给人方向，给人盼望，给人鼓舞。
To give directions, to give people hope, and to encourage those around us.
你们可以把一种全新的世界带到这个里边，让在黑暗中的人看到未来，看到真正的生命的道。
We can demonstrate what a real life, the God designed life should be like, and bring it and reveal it to the people around us.
所以神要求我们，我们在这个世界上，我们要展现出一种生命的本质来。
So we need to demonstrate that essence of that new life.
别人在我们的身上要看到我们头脑里有一种完全不同的、全新的、鲜活的思想。
So people should see through us that the thoughts in our minds that it is completely different from this world is lively.
他们要看到在我们的身上能够体现出一种特殊的、完全不同的能力。
And they should see through us that we have this power that's completely different and unknown to this world.
所以当人们看到我们的时候呢，他们就愿意和我们一同来跟随我们的神。
So when people see us, they will be willing to follow the same God that we follow.
这样呢，从我们每一个人开始，我们每一个人都被更新、被创造。
So from us and through us, that everyone will be renewed and will be changed.
那么这样逐渐逐渐的呢，这个世界上每一个人都这样被重新、被更新、被改造，神就通过这样重新来创造世界。
And gradually, the whole humanity can be changed and renewed, and this is God's reform plan.
所以弟兄姐妹们，对我们来讲，我们应该清楚一个道理：我们是身怀使命的人。
So dear brothers and sisters, we must understand we are people of mission.
为了完成这个使命，神要求我们每一个人都要成为他的见证人。
So to achieve our missions, our God asks us to live as His testimony.
让每一个人可以从我们日常的生活中，在我们的生命里面，他可以看到神的道、神的能力、神的作为和神的生命。
So that the others can see God's word, His power, His life, and His doing through our daily lives.
那么神启示我们说，为他做见证的这些生命应该是没有瑕疵的。
God revealed to us that such life testimony should be blameless and pure.
我们就好像被设定的一个标准、一个榜样，它是没有任何瑕疵的地方。
And we are the standards of this world, and we should be flawless.
没有瑕疵，就是说在我们的生命里面呢，没有任何的杂质。
So that means in our minds and thoughts, in our lives, there shouldn't be any impurities.
别人看到我们呢，当在我们身上，他看到我们这位神的形象的时候呢，他会看到什么叫做完全纯洁。
So when people look at us, they can see that the God behind us is and how pure and how perfect He is.
所以弟兄姐妹们，当我们去展望我们的未来，我们要看到呢，在我们的生命里面充满了危机，但是也充满了使命。
So when we look forward, we see that there's a lot of challenges in front of us, but also there's opportunities for us.
所以我们要去思考自己，在新的一年里面，我们要怎样努力去操练自己，我们才能达到神这样的要求。
So we really need to think about this in this new year. What are the steps we need to take to accomplish our mission?
我想在腓立比书中，保罗他告诉我们，最少从三个方面要去检讨自己。
So Paul actually talked about three things that we should examine within ourselves in this book.
那么首先呢，保罗说，他告诉我们说呢，如果你要成为神的见证人，你首先要检查自己的思想和动机，给自己一个一生之久的方向。
So firstly, we need to examine our thoughts and motives.And set ourselves a lifelong direction.
那么在第十三节呢，经文中说，因为你们立志行事，都是神在你们心里运行，为要成就他的美意。
In verse 13, it says, "For it is God who works in you and will and to act in order to fulfill His purpose."
我们应该去思考，我们检查自己，我们的心怀意念是不是都来自于神。
And we need to examine our wills and acts and to see if they are truly from God.
我们既然说我们是属于神的人，那么我们生活的中心是不是围绕着这位神？
If we claim that we are God's people, but are we really God-centered in our daily lives?
我们做的每一件事，我们说的每一句话，我们要检查一下自己的动机。你要知道你为什么要去做这件事，你的目的是什么？
And what are the motives and the ideas behind everything we say and everything we do? Is it really and truly come from God?
我们都知道呢，一个人的思想决定了一个人的行为。
And we know that one's thoughts determine his action.
我们基督徒，我们的思想呢，应该是神。
And as Christians, the foundation of our thoughts should be God.
指引我们思想行为的这个最基础的东西呢，不应该是世俗的哲学或者那些本能的想法。
This foundation, that should be God-centered and not the worldly philosophy or all instincts.
我们应该让神的心怀意念，它充满我们的生命，这样的我们的生命呢，才能有一个正确的方向。
We should let God's will be our will so that we will have the right directions in our lives.
只有这样呢，我们才能够让我们这个生命充满了韧性和力量。当我们在奔跑前路的时候啊，我们不会偏移。
So that our lives will be full of energy, that when we walk through this path of life, that we can be focused.
很多人去来到教会都愿意去追寻神的祝福。
So a lot of people, they are seeking for God's blessings when they come to church.
那么只有这样的生命呢，才会蒙受神的祝福。
But it is only the kind of lives that we described before will be blessed by God.
如果我们回首2014年。
If we look back on year 2014,
我们看一看中国大陆。
And look at China.
很多人说中国大陆2014年是一个反腐的年度，力度很大。
So a lot of people said that the anti-corruption movement was a success in China in 2014.
那么很多级别非常非常高，几乎到了顶端的官员呢，纷纷落马。
Many very very highly ranked officials got arrested.
那很多人非常高兴。
And some are very happy.
那么很多人呢也有个疑问。
But some also have some questions.
有人说，哎呀，这些人真的是坏人呐。
And they said, oh, these people are really, really bad.
那不是一般的坏。
Extraordinary bad.
他们骄奢淫欲，道德沦丧，完全没有为老百姓考虑的地方。
All they are thinking about is their own enjoyment, and they never even thought about the people who they really should serve.
那么问题就来了。
But here comes the question.
如果他们真的那么坏，他们怎么做到那么高的位置上呢？
If that's who they are, if they are this bad, how do they make their way up?
其实我们仔细地想一想，我们客观地想一想呢，我们可以很容易地得出一个答案呢、啊，就是说他们在最开始的职业生涯的时候，当他们还年轻的时候呢，他们没有这样坏。
So maybe the simple answer is that when they first started their service, when they were young, they weren't as bad.
他们原来不是这样。
They weren't like us.
他们所想的、所做的，在那个时候呢，可能是好的。
At the times they had good motives and good actions.
可能是非常好。
And maybe very good motives and actions.
他们看起来呢，在他的生命里面，他是有一个正确的方向的。
They appear to have a right direction in their lives.
按照我们通常的说法，这叫他们也曾经全心全意地为人民服务。
So as we say, maybe they're actually trying to serve those under their jurisdiction with the whole of their heart.
但是现在我们知道呢，实际上在他内心深处，去驱使他做这些服务、做这些兢兢业业的工作的时候呢，在他背后的这些动机。并不是像他想象的那样真正的去服务人民。
So maybe deep down in their hearts that the true motives for all these appear to be good deeds were not truly that good. The motives was for themselves.
可能在他们内心深处，他自己都没有意识到，他们所盼望的、努力所得到的东西呢，是自己的利益、自己的荣耀、自己的享受。所以，当有一天环境发生变化了，他们的方向呢，就发生了变化。
So maybe their true intention wasn't to serve, but it was to benefit himself or herself and to get glory and social status. And as circumstances changed, their acts changed.
当环境条件允许的时候，他内心深处最真实的这个想法，最根本的这个想法呢，就左右了他的人，就引导了他的行为。
So at times when it comes to the time that they can,do whatever they want. They will do whatever their own desire leads them to.
所以神他来问我们。
So God asks us.
你们立志行事，是不是都是神在你心里运行？目的是为要达成他的美意。
So is it truly that the wills and the acts of you are truly come from God? And it is to fulfill His good purpose?
我们基督徒呢， 应该是心思简单的人。
Us Christians should have simple minds.
我们面对我们的神，面对这个世界呢，我们的心思应该是越来越单纯。
It is simple and pure as we face the world and when we face God.
我知道呢，我们很多弟兄姐妹，很多朋友们都愿意在社会中做一个好人，做一个好基督徒。
So I know that many of us are willing to behave to be a good people in this society.
那我也很高兴，在教会中很多弟兄姐妹非常愿意来侍奉神，侍奉人。
And many of us are willing to serve in church to serve people and to serve God.
但是我们在新年的起点，我们应该去思考，你的动机是什么？
At this beginning of 2015, we really need to think about what is the true motives behind all this.
你做的每一件事，你说的每一句话，你都是为了什么？
Do you do everything you do and say everything you say for God?
所以我们要检查自己的思想和动机，给自己一个一生之久的方向，永远不偏移。
So we really need to examine our thoughts and motives and set ourselves a lifelong direction.
那么神要我们思考的第二个问题呢，就是要我们检查自己的态度，让正确的态度带给自己一颗喜乐的心。
So the second thing that the Bible tells us that we need to examine is our attitudes. The right attitude will bring a joyful heart.
那么在第十四节呢，经文说凡所行的都不要发怨言起争论。
So in verse 14 it says, do everything without grumbling or arguing.
那么怨言呢，就是不能正视自己和环境，做事情呢心不甘情不愿，抱怨。
So grumbling means that you don't really want to face yourself and the things around you. You complain about the people and the things happening around you.
那么对自己身边的这些环境事情啊，非常的不满意，不愿意呢对自己所处这种情景来负责任，想把责任呢推给别人。
You are not satisfied with anything happening around you, and you are not willing to take any responsibility of this. And you just say that this is someone else's responsibility.
那么其实说起怨言来呢，你可以说一方面呢是面对神的不满意，为什么你把我放在这个环境中啊？另一方面呢是对人觉得不公平，为什么这个人或者这件事情会这样对我？
So, these two thoughts.When we grumble, one is to say that God, why did you put me in this situation? You're complaining, and the other one is saying, why does these things, these people happen, doing this? That's not fair.
其实神呢是不喜欢人抱怨。
Do you know that God doesn't like us to be to grumble in person?
那么保罗在哥林多前书啊，他曾经非常直接地说呢，以色列人在旷野，他被神严厉的惩罚。目的呢，就是警戒这些人呐、啊，你们不要发怨言。
And Paul actually referred to the story where Israelites were punished by God in the wilderness, and for this very long reason.
因为怨言呢，它不但容易引起神的怒气，而且呢，它会破坏一个团体中啊这种和睦的爱的生活。
So grumbling is not only not pleasing to God, in reality, it actually brings arguments and conflicts between.The people in the group.
而且很容易引起争论，损害彼此之间相爱的心。
And it brings arguments and it just hurts each one another.
那么起争论呢，就是互相争吵。
Well, arguing is simple, fighting with one another.
就不愿意让步。
Well, not willing to take a step back.
是一种固执。
It's stubbornness.
是坚持自己的观点而引起的冲突。
So you are really firm on your own thinking and your thoughts.
那么我们大家都知道呢，两个人引起争执啊，这个背后的原因很多都是有过强的自我意识。
So we know that the true reason behind any argument might be because we are too self-centered.
那么怨言呢，是自我独处的时候啊，自己的一种心理表现；争论呢，是对别人的一种外在的表现。
So grumbling is what happens within us when we are alone.And arguing is what happens when we, and it's what we do to others.
其实我读到这段经文的时候很受冲击。
So actually, it really got me thinking when I read this passage.
因为我就是一个很愿意发怨言的人啊。
Because I'm like this.
后来我想到呢，每一个人都喜欢发怨言。
And then I think everyone is like this.
每一个人越努力工作呢，他就越容易发怨言。
The harder you work, the more likely you want to grumble more angry.
但是问题是说呢，神是不喜悦我们发怨言。
But the problem is that's not pleasing to God.
因为属于神的人，在一件事情上，他不会有两种不同的意见。
That means because people who belongs to God, in one circumstance, there shouldn't be many different ideas and thoughts.
你可以想象一下哈，即使是怎么去处理这件事情，怎么去做的这种简单的方法的分别，那么一定有好的，有次好的。
So there's always a better solution to one thing.
那么如果有分歧的话，那是不是就是说神愿意有些人他就去选择那个次好的呢？不对，不是这样。神都希望我们去选择那个最好的。
So if there's a disagreement, or if there's something that's apparently better than one than the other, is that God's will for some to choose the not so good ones? Not really. God wants us to choose the best ones.
所以属于神的人呢，在面对神的事情，我们没有理由啊，会出现分歧的意见。
So for God's people, and if we were truly doing things for God, we should have one end solution.
那么其实不但如此啊，在圣经中呢，神告诉我们，属于神的人，在神的带领之下做神的事工的时候呢，神为这些人预备的是平安喜乐。
And also God promised His people that when we do things for Him, He will give us peace and joy.
耶稣基督说，我的轭是清醒的。
Jesus said, "My burden is light."
意思是说呢，虽然在我们的生活里面，我们会遇到很多困难险阻，但是我们在面对这些事情的时候，我们的心依然是充满了快乐。
So even though we might still face challenges, but we should still be able to experience the peace and joy through Jesus Christ.
有过发怨言的经历的人可以想一想，我最近经常在想。其实当你发怨言起争论的时候呢，自己是很痛苦的。
So, for those of you who have actually complained before, you might notice this. When you complain, maybe within yourself, it is not that easy for you too.
一个发怨言起争执的人呢，他是一个失去喜乐的。
A person who complains a lot, he doesn't have joy.
这不是神所期待的。
And that's not what they want.
也不是神设计给属于他的子民。
And that's not what his intent for his people.
所以我们在面对新的一年的时候呢，我们要去思考，我们怎样去建立一个神所赐给我们这样的一个喜乐的心。
So in this new year, we really need to think about this. How can we retain this joyful heart that God intended for us?
我们首先呢，我们要去想啊，神的事情，既然是他的事情呢，我们是他的管道。我们完全地依靠他的时候呢，我们没有什么可需要抱怨的。
So we need to know for the work of God that it is His work and we're only the channels that is done through. So there's nothing for us to complain about.
那么再回过头来看我们自己的时候，我们也要清楚，在属于神的群体之中，你要记得呢，我们的神从来都是引导，他从来不会强迫人。
So when we look back onto ourselves in terms of serving God, we really must understand that God doesn't force us.
圣经中说，到什么地步就按什么地步行。
So the Bible says that you should our action should follow our faith.
意思是说呢，神希望你来到他的国里面，希望你成为他的子民，他希望你快乐。任何人、任何事工、任何事情，你愿意做，那么你就高高兴兴地做。做之前呢，就算好代价；不愿意做呢，我们不需要勉强自己，因为我们还没有到那个地步。
So God wants us to be happy, to be joyful in our lives. So He knows, and He wants us to know that for whatever we do for Him, there's a price to pay. Before you decided that you want to do it, you need to make sure you're willing to pay the price.
神不希望我们一件事情做了还满腹牢骚。
So if you are not willing, don't do it. But don't complain. Start complaining when you say you want to do it.
神不希望呢？我们一边做一边互相的攀比，说我怎么做这些事情，为什么那个人不做呢？
And don't compare yourselves with others and say, how come I got a lot on my shoulders, yet he's not doing anything?
弟兄姐妹们，我们要知道在神的国里面有一个法则。
So we must know that this thing in God's kingdom.
你做的越多，你得到的祝福就越多。
the more blessings there is, the more that you do for him.
神给了你很多的东西，他才会向你索取更多。
Because he gave you a lot, so that's why he's asking a lot from you.
所以我在读这段经文的时候呢，我觉得神他真的触摸我。
So I was really touched by God when I read this passage.
我下定决心在2015年，我不做一个发牢骚的人。
So I said to myself, I will not complain in year 2015.
因为我要用一个喜乐的心去面对这个世界。
Because I want to face this world with a joyful heart.
所以弟兄姐妹们，我们要想一想，我们做基督徒，我们在这个世界上生活，我们是不是像神所应许的那样喜乐呢？
So dear brothers and sisters, when we look at ourselves, when we are living in this world, are we truly showing that joy that God has promised us?
所以我们应该学习呢，从不发怨言开始。
So we must start learning from not complaining.
让我们有一个喜乐的心面对未来。
So that we will have a joyful heart, then that we can face the challenges ahead.
在第十五节呢，保罗说：“使你们无可指摘，诚实无伪。”
So in verse 15, Paul says, "So that you may become blameless and pure or innocent."
神要求我们检查自己的行为，让我们诚实无伪的品格成为我们影响力的源泉。
So that God wants us to examine our actions and to have a character that's blameless and innocent is the source of our influence.
你仔细地看这句经文呢，你会发现呢，神在这里强调的呢是诚实，而不是完美。
So if you look at this passage carefully, you will see that God has emphasized on blameless or innocent.But not perfect.
一个诚实的人呢，他不见得是一个伟大的人。
A innocent person may not be a flawless or great person.
什么叫做诚实啊？是就是是，不是就是不是。
What's innocent? A yes is a yes, and no is a no.
他可以有错误，他可以有缺点，但是他愿意把这些错误和缺点表明在众人面前。
He could also make mistakes and have shortcomings, but he's willing to admit his shortcomings.
他愿意把自己一切呢都展示在神的光照之下。
So he's willing to show that he's imperfect.
所以别人可能知道呢，这个人是有缺点。
So others may know that he is not perfect.
但是知道呢，他是一个坦诚的人。
But he's an innocent and pure person.
他不虚伪，他就是他。
He doesn't pretend, and he is who he is.
当我们跟别人接触的时候呢，这样的人是让我们感到放心的人。
So when we have dealings with people like this, we can trust him.
因为我们知道呢，除了他袒露的这些错误之外，他不会再有一些潜在的问题。
Because we know the apart from those that the shortcomings that he showed, there won't be anything else for us to worry about.
你跟他交往的时候，不会再出现新的意外。
So there's no surprise.
一个人再坏，也就是这样，不会再坏了。
So he is probably as bad as he is showing now. There won't be any worse. He won't be any worse.
一个诚实的人呢，他让人无可指摘。
So an innocent person will become blameless.
因为他就是那样嘛。
Because that is who he is.
所以没有什么可挑剔的。
So there's nothing to be picky about.
你想一想你的经验中，这样的人呢，往往是人们愿意同他交往。
So think of it, maybe these kind of people are the ones people who are willing to have, make friendship with them.
那么一个人对自己身边的人，对身边的世界的影响力呢，也就从这里开始。
And that's where his influence starts.
在圣经中我们知道，我们的救主耶稣基督，他最讨厌的事情呢，就是假冒为善。
And when we read the Bible, we know that Jesus Christ really blames those hypocrites.
假冒为善的人呢，就是虚伪的。
Those who pretend,
戴一个面具
who wears masks when dealing with people.
这样的人呢，可能某些事情做得很好，可能在某一段时间之内呢，他表现得很好，但是在他的里面呢，总有一些隐瞒的东西。
These people appear to be good people on the surface, but you know that there's something wrong. There's something always something hiding behind the surface.
一旦有一天，当这些东西被人发现的时候呢，就会造成一种偶像的崩塌。
So if one day when these things were on the surface were discovered, the image they try very hard to maintain will fall down or break immediately.
这也是圣经中所说的呢，让人指摘。
So this is for people who can we can pick on those people.
在我的信仰里面，在我的服事里面呢，我至始至终我就贯穿一个想法，就是要做一个真实的人。
So, throughout my Christian life, I always thought that I want to be an honest person, an innocent person.
我知道我有很多错误，有很多缺点。
I know that I have many flaws, I have many shortcomings.
但是在我面对神的时候，我有一个底线永远不会突破，就是真实。
But when I face God and when I talk to God, there's this one thing that I will hold always. That is, I want to be true with Him.
因为面对神的时候，你是无可隐瞒的。
Because when you face God, there's nothing you can hide from Him.
我努力做到对人要真实。
I try my best to do the same with people as well.
因为圣经说，隐藏的事必然显明出来。
Because the Bible says that whatever you're trying to hide will eventually be revealed.
我努力呢，要对自己去真实。
I'm trying to be honest with myself too.
我不希望有一天当我回首自己过去的时候，我会讨厌自己。
I don't want to hate myself when I look back on myself one day in the future.
所以弟兄姐妹们，在新的一年里边呢，我们怎样成为神的见证人？怎样让我们被更多的人所接纳，把神的道能够彰显出来
？So dear brothers and sisters, in this new year, how are we going to act? What should we do so that more and more people can accept us or what we believe in?
我想我们应该从对自己真实开始。
And I think the key is to be honest with yourself.
当我们诚实无伪、无可指摘的时候呢，神的道在我们身上就彰显出来。
So when we become blameless and pure or innocent, God's will is actually manifested through us.
所以弟兄姐妹们，我们要去思想，在这个时代，我们怎样去生活。
So we need to think, how are we going to live our daily lives in this world?
神启示我们，在这个弯曲悖谬的时代，要做他的见证人。
So God wants us to be His testimony in this rough and crooked generation.
他要求我们把这个道传播出去。
He asks to spread His gospel.
这个是我们的使命。
And that is our mission.
其实这个也是对我们的奖赏。
And it is actually our reward.
因为在这样操练的过程里边呢，我们可以真正的去明白自己生命的目标，可以明白我们生命的意义。
Because through doing this, we'll get to understand our ultimate purpose in our lives.
只有在这样的过程里面呢，我们才可以找到我们每一天的喜乐。
And only through doing this that we can find joy and peace in our daily life.
我们可以每一天呢活得坦然，活得轻松。我们会觉得呢，原来这就是神所赐给我们。
So we can relax and we can truly face ourselves. And this is what God really wants for us.
其实如果你通读圣经，你会发现呢，圣经正告诉我们呢，我们基督徒生命的成长呢，正是这样一天心思一天。
So if you read the Bible, you will know that for us Christians to grow, that we really need to be renewed daily.
所以在这里边，使徒保罗呢，他用了一个词来描述我们面对这种过程的一个状态。
So Paul used this word to describe this process and this situation.
他说你们要恐惧战惊。
So he says that you need to fear and tremble.
你非常认真地去面对这个过程。
So you look at this and very seriously.
然后你做成你得救的功夫。
And you work out your own salvation.
他说你这个是为你的祝福，为神的给你的救赎在工作。
So the works that you're doing is for your salvation and for the reward of God.
作为一个海外的华人啊，在西方生活呢，我们每一次到了这个时间呢，我们都是非常幸福。
For us Chinese in Eastern world, we are very lucky during this time of the year.
也对比一下这个洋人呢，他们新的一年已经开始。
So for Westerners, the new year has started.
那对于我们来讲呢，我们好像始终慢半拍。
Then for us, I think yes, but not yet.
因为我们还要过春节呢嘛。
Because we have the Chinese New Year.
过了春节，我们才觉得一年才重新开始。
So we probably think that the New Year starts when we had the Chinese New Year.
那今年呢，我们有六分之一都在等待着啊。
So we have one-sixth of the year in waiting for the New Year.
不过呢，这都没有关系，不要紧。
That's alright.
无论是现在你准备开始新的一年，还是下个月你才开始准备开始一年，不要紧。
Whether that you your New Year's stats a couple weeks ago or your New Year's stats next month, that's fine.
当你真正明白神的旨意的时候呢，你新的起点就建立起来。
So, when you truly understand God's will, your new starting point is here.
当你找到这个新的起点，你的新的一年就真正开始。
And then your new year is starting.
我甚愿我们的神祝福我们每一个。
I really wish that our God bless every single one of us here.
我们可以找到我们一生之久的方向。
And then we can find the lifelong direction of our lives.
我们也可以有一颗喜乐的心。
And then we can also have a joyful heart.
我们也可以呢成为一个有影响力的人。
And then we can be influential.
所以我们要检查自己。
So we have to examine ourselves.
时时警醒。
Every moment.
我们可以警醒镇静地去做成我们得救的功夫。
And we will be alert and to work out for our own salvation.
愿神祝福我们。
May God bless us.
让我们一同来祷告。
Let us pray.
天父上帝，我们真的是感谢你的恩典。
Lord, we thank you for your grace and your salvation.
当我们面向新的一年的时候，我们把我们自己放在你的手中。
And we put ourselves in your hands in this new year.
我们知道在我们的生命里面有很多的挑战，很多的难度。
We know that there are many challenges in our lives.
但是我们知道你是君王，你已经战胜了这一切。
But we know that you are the king and you have overcome all of these.
天父上帝，愿你把你的信心赐给我们。
And we pray that you will give us your faith.
所以我们可以坦然无惧地去过你给我们地上的生活。
So that we can live our lives without fear.
我们不逃避。
We will not escape from the reality.
我们也不恐惧。
And we will not fear what's ahead of us.
我们求你给我们喜乐的心。
We pray that you give us a joyful heart.
让我们看见我们的未来，我们的道路。
So that we can see what's ahead of us.
也求你的圣灵来浇灌我们。
And we ask that your spirit to be with us.
求你复兴我们。
Please revive us.
在2015年，求你复兴我们。
Revive us in the year 2015.
让我们成为你的见证人，成为一个有影响力的人。
That we may be your testimony and we can be influential.
我们可以成为你赐给冠冕的人。
So that we can be crowned.
天父上帝，我们把我们自己，把我们每一个人，我们放在你的面前，愿你来带领我们。
And we put everyone here in front of you, and may you lead us.
我们把我们自己仰望，我们祷告，奉靠救主耶稣基督的名。
We pray in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.